Hello, I'm Calvin LeDuc, and this is how to create a playblast. So we have our Maya scene open here, and the most difficult way is to go up to Windows and search for playblast, about 3/4 of the way down, and that's not how I do it. I just right-click on the timeline, and the first option at the bottom is playblast. Always go to the option box, and now you want to change the format from AVI, which is incredibly heavy, and your scenes will play slowly. And you want to select QT for QuickTime. And then it's very important that QuickTime is already downloaded onto your computer in order to have QuickTime as a option for your format. Next, the encoding. The encoding, you might have to scroll up or down, and we find the best one to use is H.264. Quality, that's your preference. Definitely for loading to the school, you should set it at 100%. But when you're creating playblast for yourself, it can be somewhere between 70-80%. It'll just create the playblast faster and it'll be a smaller file size. Display size, probably want to set it at custom. And we want to be working with high definition aspect ratio, which is 16:9. So that would be 720x405. And if that's the exact size we want for pixels, the scaling should be at 100%. Which is just a scale of 1. Frame paddings, 3 or 4 is fine. Now you have two options for the way that it's creating your playblast. The first is remove temporary file. And when you click on playblast, it'll make the movie, but once you close that movie, it removes it. It's gone. It's not saving it anywhere. The other option is save to file. And now you have to browse to where you want to be saving. I've already created a project for my snowman, so when I click on Browse, it's going to navigate into my project, which is in my Documents, Snowman Jump Project, and it's going to put it directly into my Movies folder. So go down to File Name, give it a good name. The scene is Snowman Jump, so a good name for the movie would be Snowman Jump, and a number. I'm going to do _01, and so always have a name and then a number convention. So start with 1, 2, 3, 4. Don't just use words. Nobody will know which is the newest file. So click on save, and now I can hit playblast. It's going to go through, create a movie of all those frames, and then it's going to open up my file. You might have to actually go in. So let's just close that for a second, and I'll open up my folder and look for my movies file. And it might be in some other format. It might be in, let's say, open with VLC. Okay, and let's just convert all of them to VLC. So give me 1 second. So here what we're opening is a VLC movie. And you might have to go into your folder and actually ask it to open with QuickTime. And that's what you should be opening and studying your playblast movie in QuickTime. It allows you to go through individual frames. So same process, open with. And if you're only doing it once, you just click on QuickTime Player. But if you want all of your movies to open with QuickTime Player, choose another app. Click always open this app to open up your movie files and click on QuickTime Player. So here's our playblast, and click on it once and it plays. If you're doing a cycle, the option is Control plus L to loop it. And then when you click on play, it'll just continuously loop the action over and over if, let's say, the character's walking. So that's how to create a playblast. Thanks for watching.